O come. Rejoice in the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Morning, everyone, and welcome to our morning prayer on this Friday morning. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. And we begin with some verses from Psalm 95. O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving and be glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the heights of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have moulded the dry land. Come. Let us worship and bow down and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and for ever. Amen. Our psalm for today is Psalm 51. Have mercy on me, O God, in your great goodness. According to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my offences. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my faults and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and righteous in your judgment. I have been wicked even from my birth, a sinner where my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth deep within me. and shall make me understand wisdom in the depth of my heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me hear of joy and gladness, that the bones you have broken may rejoice. Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my misdeeds. Make a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me again the joy of your salvation, and sustain me with your gracious spirit. Then shall I teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from my guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise, for you desire no sacrifice, else I would give it. You take no delight in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. And our reading this morning is from Luke's Gospel, chapter 14, and beginning to verse 12. Jesus has been invited to the home of a leader of the Pharisees. It's a place where he's not comfortable, because he knows that people are watching him and waiting for him to say something that they can use against him. Then Jesus turned to his host. When you put on a luncheon or a dinner, he said, don't invite your friends, brothers, relatives, and rich neighbours, for they will repay you by inviting you back. Instead, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame and the blind. Then, at the resurrection of the godly, God will reward you for inviting those who could not repay you. Hearing this, a man sitting at the table with Jesus exclaimed, "What a privilege it would be to have a share in the kingdom of God!" Jesus replied with this illustration. A man prepared a great feast and sent out many invitations. When all was ready, he sent his servants around to notify the guests that it was time for them to come. But they all began making excuses. One said he had just bought a field and wanted to inspect it, so he asked to be excused. Another said he had just bought 5 pair of oxen and wanted to try them out. Another had just been married, so he said he couldn't come. The servant returned and told his master what they had said. His master was angry and said, "Go quickly into the streets and alleys of the city and invite the poor, the crippled, the lame and the blind." After the servant had done this, he reported, "There is still room for more." So his master said, "Go out into the country lanes and behind the hedges and urge anyone you find to come, so that the house will be full. For none of those I invited first will get even the smallest taste of what I have prepared for them." This is the word of the Lord. And our canticle is from the prophet Hosea, chapter 6. Come, let us return to the Lord who has torn us and will heal us. God has stricken us and will bind up our wounds. After 2 days he will revive us, and on the 3rd day will raise us up that we may live in his presence. Let us strive to know the Lord. His appearing is as sure as the sunrise. He will come to us like the showers, like the spring rains that water the earth. O Ephraim, How shall I deal with you? How shall I deal with you, O Judah? Your love for me is like the morning mist, like the dew that goes early away. Therefore I have hewn them by the prophets, and my judgment goes forth as the light. For loyalty is my desire, and not sacrifice, and the knowledge of God, rather than burnt offerings. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be evermore. Amen. And this is the song of Zechariah. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. And the collect for today. Gracious Father, you gave up your Son out of love for the world. Lead us to ponder the mysteries of his passion, that we may know eternal peace through the shedding of our Saviour's blood, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And our reading today was from Luke's Gospel, chapter 14. And it's the well-known parable of the great wedding feast. You recall the feast was ready and prepared, but the people who were invited found all sorts of reasons not to go. So the man who'd invited his ungrateful guests, in some versions Jesus calls him the king, but in this case he's a rich man. But he sends out his servants to find anyone who would come. Now the conversation around the table has been of the messianic banquet in the kingdom of heaven. So the message of the parable is quite clear. Jesus had come to invite people to be part of the kingdom. The religious people, and remember, he was talking to the Pharisees around the table, spurned his invitation. So now he's inviting the ordinary people, those whom the Pharisees looked down on, and the less reputable ones at that, the tax collectors and the prostitutes. People who the Pharisees anyway would regard as spiritually poor, crippled, lame, blind. But even when they come in, there is room. So the man invites the Gentiles from the country lanes and behind the hedges. And that's us. We enter the kingdom, not by right, but because we have a royal invitation. So we remember that as we go into our prayers. Lord, you withhold no good thing from us, and you lavish us with the treasures of heaven. Help us to seek your kingdom first, and to lay aside anything that might hinder us from doing your will. Give us your eyes, that we might see around us your precious children and your honoured dinner guests, and we might have the strength to love and serve them. And so we pray for this day and whatever comes our way. Help us to be friendly and kind to whoever we meet. Help us to curb any impatience and any unkind words which may come to our lips. Give us the courage to do what is right, no matter what it might cost. And may we remember always that everything we do can be offered to you as an act of worship, so that when evening comes on this day, and this day is over, we may not be ashamed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so, remembering Jesus' parable, we pray for those who are poor, crippled, lame and blind, those who are suffering in any way, whether due to illness, physical or mental, or through illness or isolation or anxiety, those who are held fast by addictions, and those whose lives seem to have gone wrong, people who are anxious, vulnerable and fearful, for the gravely ill and the dying. And we pray that they may sense your love and your presence with them, and respond to that invitation you extend to them to share the joy of your kingdom. And so let's pause there, and you have the opportunity now to enter the name of anybody you know into the comment box so it can be shared, or if you wish, just offer it to God in the silence. People who need God's help at this time. We remember those who have no one to pray for them, and those who have little or no family support. And we pray for all those that we've thought about and those that we've mentioned, that you would strengthen and help them in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for all those who are caring for the sick, whether family or professional health workers, for doctors, nurses, paramedics, orderlies and other NHS staff, that through their combined care and skill, many would be restored to health. We pray for the staff in care homes, and indeed for all carers, as they act as agents of your healing touch. Keep them strong yet loving, and when their work is done, be with them in their weariness and in their tears. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for those who are guiding our nation at this time and shaping national policies, that they may make wise decisions for the benefit of all. We remember the Prime Minister and the Cabinet, local councillors and MPs, that the loosening of the breakdown might be judged well, and that economic benefits may be balanced by any increase in infections. We pray for our local schools. And particularly we think of Christchurch and Ellesmereport College. We just think of the teachers and children and all school staff. And as we pray for our own leaders, we remember the troubles of countries overseas, and we pray for their leaders. We think of the United States. We pray for the people of the poorer nations of the world, with their particular problems, places like Syria and the Yemen and parts of Africa, where there is open war. So perhaps you might like to bring to God now countries and situations which are particularly on your heart. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so we end our prayer with the prayer of Ignatius of Loyola. Teach us, good Lord, to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labour and not to ask for any reward except that of knowing that we do your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we bring these prayers to our Father as we say together the prayer that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And so may the Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Amen.